Hey, how's it going, everybody? This is J-Rod. This is my channel, All the Above. I'm doing a tutorial on how to change out the thermal pads. Figured we'd do a little walkthrough. Pretty simple. And the video is pretty self-explanatory. So you're going to take off. There's six screws on the back. And as you can see, I'm on the last screw. After we take all those screws off, we got to keep in mind that there is a connection for the fan, and we're going to disconnect that fan. Everybody has a different way. Me, I separate it first, and then I kind of just put it in a situation where I can get the little tab off. It's a regular 4-pin fan that connects into it. So just kind of pull on it. If it doesn't feel like it's coming out, you can get a screwdriver in it. But there it is right there. So then after that, you can separate it. Me, I take off my thermal pads and I kind of do a pattern of what the GPU is. So then this way, when I'm putting it back, it makes it a little easier to be able to measure the size of the GPU thermal pads, and it makes it easier because you kind of know where they're located on there. After doing one of these, of course, your second one will be so much easier. And this is all a learning curve. If this is your first GPU thermal pad change out, typically we use isopropyl alcohol 99%, but you can get away with the 91%. I use both, and I'll buy it and I'll mix them. The higher percentage, the better it is drying wise, but both of them will work. So basically, I get a bucket and I will. You can be real thorough and get like a squirt bottle. You can actually fill this bucket up with more and submerge the actual GPU. Me personally, I just kind of get it as best as I can. Also, you can take a paper towel to dab it and dry it. You can also use a blow dryer to dry it out. All right, after we get both sides fully washed, we got to keep in mind that we will save this bucket. We will be using it again. There's going to be four screws that we got to take out in order to clean the fan side. Now, that's usually the side that gets the dust in it. So I typically will clean it. You can avoid taking this part off and spraying it with some liquid air. So I do that also, but for this tutorial purpose, I will show you exactly how it comes off. The great part about taking this part off is it can't go in backwards. If you try flipping it, it will not go in. The screws won't line up. So it's mistake proof. You can't make a mistake on this. There's four screws and it will separate, as you can see. And then this is the side that I like to clean because this is the side that gets pretty dusty. Now I will clean it with the toothbrush, and I use electronic duster, and this stuff works great. You can buy it at Walmart or online, but this stuff's good for a quick fix, but also it helps you while you're cleaning. So also, I take the toothbrush and I get the dust off of the fan blades, the inside of the GPU. Not only am I changing out the thermal pads, but I'm also cleaning the GPU, which we all already knew that. But this is the part I was saying, that you can't put it in wrong. No matter what, it'll go in the correct way. It'll only go in one way. The screws will only line up one way on this, so you can't get this part wrong. So I kind of left it in the video. I didn't cut it to kind of show an example of, you know, how it can't go in backwards. So don't ever feel like, oh, did I get it upside down? Because it won't, that part won't go in upside down on this GPU model. So, all right, next we're going to put the screws back. And again, it's four screws. Don't, I repeat, don't screw the screws in if they don't line up. That's just, you know, the rule of thumb. If they don't line up, then it does not fit, then it's not correct. All right, the next part we're going to be tackling is the thermal pads. And with this GPU model, I found that using 1.5 millimeter, 0.5 millimeter, and 1 millimeter on this GPU. If you have different sizes for this exact model, please put it down in the comment, because I found that these are the sizes that work great. Now, the pieces that I'm placing on it right now are the 1 millimeter. These are 1 millimeter. The spot that I just pointed to is the actual spot that, look, I'll show you right here, that is 0.5 millimeter, which is a little bit thinner. And, you know, honestly, I don't know why they used, obviously it's the design, but they used three different sizes on this GPU. But if you have any issues or discrepancies, you can look it up. Also, you can see how in the top left corner how I got all my pads on there. You can kind of place your measurements at that size and figure out, okay, this is this size, this is that size, you know. Or you could buy a ruler. I mean, they're pennies on the dollar. So me personally, I've got a bunch of different cards. So me personally, I have from 0.5 all the way up to 3 millimeters. You know, I've got, what, 6 or 7 different sizes, because you just never know. And then obviously the sizes that I use the most, like 1 millimeter and 0.5, I get a little more of. You can buy these on Amazon, and they come with a whole big sheet, as you can see in this video. So as you can see in this video, how I determined where the pads went, I just kind of did my diagram in the back, and I just put them in the exact same spot that they were in. Again, that's why when I open up this card, I take this card apart and I pulled the thermal pads off exactly the way that they went on. And I kind of do my diagram that way on the actual surface that I'm working with. And then that'll give me an idea of, okay, this went with this, this went with that. And it just makes it a lot easier. All right, next we're going to apply thermal paste. And we're going to do a good amount. Some people get scared with putting a little bit too much on there. Me personally, put enough to where it has contact with the cooler. This is the name of the game. You want your thermal pads to touch the cooler. You want your thermal paste to touch the cooler. Otherwise, it's not going to cool it down. So let's make sure it does that. And then next, we're going to do the same scenario with plugging our fan back in. We're going to plug our fan in. We're going to make sure that it's connected all the way, 100%. And then you can kind of see how it lines up. And I show you kind of a little bit in this video. And it just, there you go. Clicks right in. This card was one of the easier cards that I've done with the thermal pads. I mean, you're done after you put that spot in. There's no backplate. The board is the back plate. So, okay, now we just make sure that it's nice and tight. We are going to put all our screws back in, and with our screws, we kind of go in like an X pattern. You want to do an X pattern to keep this board tight in all corners. Me personally, I'll flip around. If you ever put a tire on, you don't just go left to right. You want to go around it, side to side. And that's kind of the same scenario with the GPU. And then this will keep it, this will give it contact with the thermal paste and the thermal pads in an even manner all the way around. So there it is. There is your installment. You did it. Congratulations. Proud of you. Please leave your comments below. And also, please subscribe. Please check my channel out. It's a new channel, but please subscribe. Thanks.